everybody, and welcome to the Big DIY. On today's episode, how to read a tape measure. The one thing in my 20 plus years of being around home improvements that I've noticed is people that don't know how to read a tape measure properly. There's no guilt in not knowing how to do something. There's guilt in not willing to learn. So in today's video, I'm hoping to help you out a little bit and understanding a tape measure just a little bit better. Again, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're first-timers to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And as always, please share it with your family and friends. I hope you enjoy this episode of the Big DIY. All right, in today's episode, we're going to learn how to use a tape measure ruler. This here is a 25-foot cobalt magnetic tip tape measure. Magnetic tip being there's a magnet here that if I was to go to something metal and I didn't have somebody else to hold the other end of the tape measure for me, it would just click right on. Makes it very nice and easy. Has a great lip here if you need to click on something as well. But we're going to learn how to read a tape measure today. I have a lot of people in my years of doing construction and home improvements ask me, Andrew, how do you read a tape measure? What are all these little lines in between the inch, 2 inch, and so on and so forth? Well, that's what we're going to go over today. First of all, most tape measures are going to be yellow or a lime green like this one, just making it easier for you to read everything. Your first 12 inches is going to show just minor stuff on how to go from 0 to 12. This tape measure, however, once you hit the 12 mark, shows you 1 foot 1, 1 foot 2, 1 foot 3. It definitely allows you to use your tape measure a little better. You're not having to add all the stuff together. Now, some people ask, why is the 16, the 32, and the 48 red? And it's actually more than that. So your basic studs in your home, or wherever it may be, are 16 inches on center. So when you're showing your tape measure on the wall, and you need the mark where your studs have to go, well, that's why it's highlighted. 16, 32, 48, and so on and so forth. Every 16 inches, you will see it marked in red. That lets you know that you are 16 inches on center. But today's overall mission is to tell you how to read your tape measure when it comes to all these little lines. So the easiest way I've always explained to people is imagine that an inch is a dollar. And in a dollar, there's 4 quarters. Each quarter represents these large lines that you see right here. Those are your quarter marks. So we have 1 quarter, 2 quarters, 3 quarters, and a full inch. Just like you would have on money, quarter, 25 cents, half, 50 cents, 3 quarters, 75 cents, and then a full dollar. Now, a lot of people ask me what these lines in between are. Each one of these lines represents a 16th of an inch. Now, just to do some simple math, there are 16 16ths in an inch. There are 16 of these lines. So, for every 16th, you have a line. Now, a lot of people say to me, okay, well, why is this line, the second line, bigger than the line before it? Well, on tape measures, they break it down into 16ths, eighths, quarters, another eighth, half, another eighth, 3 quarters, another eighth, full. So, when you get to, let's just say, this one right here, between the quarter and half, that's not your second eighth, that's your third eighth. So as you can see, every other line is an eighth. Now, for those that are not that great at math, which some people are, when it's okay, don't worry about all that. Worry about the quarters, the half, the three-quarter. Worry about the individual lines. I've worked at large home improvement stores before. I've had people come in and say to me, Andrew, I don't know how to read a tape measure, but it was 4 inches and a couple of lines. Well, how many lines? There's 4 lines. Okay, So that's a quarter. So my suggestion to you is, even if you cannot understand a tape measure overall, count how many lines. So if you need something that's 3 6/16, so you're going to tell them, I need 3 6/16. Let us tell you that's 3 3/8. We'd rather you come in with a basic measurements like the 16ths than come in and tell us, I don't know. Now, there are other tape measures out there that will show you on the tape measure itself each one of those marks. It'll show you 16th, 8th, quarter. It'll have it written on there like it does for the 1 foot, 2, 3, 4. It'll have those marks on there as well for you. So one suggestion is, if you do not understand how to read a tape measure still, go and get yourself one of those tape measures that has that on there. This way, if you want to, you know, appear that you know what you're talking about, you can know what you're talking about. I hope today's video helped you out a little bit. I'm definitely up for showing anybody that needs to learn how to use a tape measure properly in person. As always, if you're a first timer, please subscribe. Make sure you share the video with all your friends and family if you like it. And if you do like it, give it a thumbs up. Until next time, have a great day. This is the Big DIY.